Carlos invited me to respond, being quiet over here. Dan, I hope our audience won't be tired if we continue a discussion that we've had over the years, but if I ask myself this question, why, in actuality, does the United States want to hold on to thousands of nuclear weapons for Obama's lifetime, because he says that he won't get to abolition in his lifetime? I feel that, notwithstanding hearing what you just had to say, that I don't know what the answer is. In other words, even in terms of a threat, I mean, you made the great point that, that these are used, they're not detonated, but they are used in the sense of being threatened. But what is the desire at this moment in history with no Soviet Union and so forth? We got there because there was a Soviet Union, no question about it. Now it's gone. What's it all about? I don't get it. I'm ashamed to admit it. I'm supposed to know about these things.
As you say, this is a continuing discussion between Jonathan and me. There is no one in the world that I have more respect for on these matters than Jonathan, and whose passion against nuclear weapons is like mine, is the same. But there is a subject on which we disagree. It's not clear, though, from this point you just raised, that there's that much disagreement, really. I'm not saying that there is a reason that it makes sense.
Well, what's the one that doesn't make sense? What's the one that doesn't make sense? I want to know why.
Oh, yeah. The targets, I think I know very well from what has leaked out and what is said. And by the way, a great deal more discussion in these matters than there used to be when I was working on the workplace, which was very closely held at this time. Now, civilians have been working on this for a generation or two. There's really a lot known about what the current plans look like, meaning they look like the same ones that looked like 40 years ago. And so I can answer the question with great confidence. What are those targets for those weapons? Do they have targets, or are they saying, gee, you know, who are we targeting? What do we do with all these weapons? Oh no, they think they don't have enough weapons. No. And many people in the Pentagon feel we need more weapons. And I want to make it clear, by the way, this NPR, I'm not saying it couldn't be worse. It could be worse. It probably would be worse under McCain and Palin. Even worse. I'm not setting the bar too low in my mind. But coming back, they would be, the targets, though, in this case, are the same as they would be under McCain. And they include every command and control post in the Soviet Union. They include all of the defense networks, which are quite extensive, all the missiles, the submarine bases, and most of the cities. So they have targets for them, and the idea is, as before, they're simply targeting them as before. Now, I will say this, so I think you can agree very much. I could give you a rationale for why we supposedly needed all that. For, say, between 1965 and 1965, earlier, from the beginning of the Cold War to the end of the Cold War. Now, that rationale disappeared, so it's hardly worth mentioning at this point. We could talk about it, but that really isn't there, as we said. And without that rationale, there really isn't much of a rationale. It's a matter of inertia. It's services who don't want to give up their leg of the triad. It's jobs, in effect. Jobs, I just read the other day, by the way, that communities in Idaho and elsewhere are objecting very strongly to the possibility that they may lose the Minuteman silos. And I think that has everything to do, because of the jobs, that has everything to do with why they simply demerged the Minuteman, which was good in itself, down to one warhead, and didn't dismantle the Minuteman. The Minuteman should have gone away 30 or 40 years ago. But they're there because there are profits to be made, there are people whose jobs depend on them.
So we are
somebody at the lowest level, supposedly, cannot independently, an individual, retarget those weapons away from the, it doesn't take 3 minutes, it's probably closer to 30 seconds, to click, to change those targets back to their pre-assigned targets, and the pre-assigned targets are in Russia, then, and also in a number of other countries. So, that has nothing to do with the feeding. Now, on the question of having the number of vehicles, my understanding, and here I'm not on all the details, but what I've been reading lately is we are already below the idea that we're allowed to move in the 1600. These were vehicles we weren't using.
I think
we're under 800, and the fact is that this agreement will not change the number of vehicles at all.
No, but they locked
what?
We've locked it in place for the treaty.
Yeah,
I mean, we won't go back to 600.
And I think Kenneth has a good point, because after all, you know, there was a Cold War high of some 70,000 nuclear warheads. Now it's down, you know, by 3/4 or whatever it is. It's probably not quite comparable figures on the warheads. I noticed that people applauded when you mentioned the money, and certainly the money is always there, and the money will always win if it's not opposed. And yet you can beat the money. And even the reductions do show that. So I want to reassert my question. I feel it's still not answered. Why? What is the irrational, rational, or something else reason that we want to have these weapons? I wish I knew that, because I think it's the driving engine of the nuclear age.
I'm the least informed on the panel, and so it obviously has fallen to me to answer your question.